The FIVB Beach Volleyball World Tour is in Russia as the best players on the planet battle it out for Grand Slams glory here at the Beach Sports Center. All the action to come from the men's semis right here in Moscow. Hello, welcome to Centre Court as we get ready for men's volleyball action here on the FIVB Beach Volleyball World Tour. First of two semi-finals to come. The Netherlands in the form of Reindeer Numidor and Christian Verenhorst up against the USA's Jacob Gibb and Casey Patterson. On the other half, it's Wosiak and Kantor of Poland against Allison and Bruno. That game will come up directly after this one, but all our focus is on this particular game right now and who it will be that will guarantee themselves a medal by making it through to the final. Their warm-up, and it's time for the referee to make his way safely up the stand. Roman Ristovakin from Russia is in charge today. Was in Cincinnati last week referee. Now he finds himself back here, and he's ably assisted by Portugal's very own Rui Carvalho. Two quality referees.
Please welcome the second referee, Olympic referee from Portugal, Mr. Rui Carvalho.
Carvalho was refereeing the Olympic final in 2012. So first glimpse of the Netherlands. Reindeer Numidor, number one, 39 years of age. He's an expectant father to be. Manon Fleer, his partner, is due to have their baby anytime soon. But his attention's at the moment on the volleyball. Could well be his last season on tour. Been playing for 11 seasons, has 11 career wins, $604,000 in prize money. His playing partner, just 26 years of age, Christian Verenhorst from The Hague. Two career wins, $259,000 in prize money. These two were in the final in The Hague of the World Championships last year, just missing out to Allison and Bruno. So for the USA, out comes Jacob Gibb, 40 years of age now, from Huntington Beach, California. Six golds, $667,000 in prize money. His playing partner, the 36-year-old Casey Patterson. Two golds, $265,000 in prize money. Netherlands in blue serving, USA in red receiving. This is the first semi-final from the men's event of the Moscow Grand Slam, part of the FIVB Beach Volleyball World Tour. Gibb, with no trouble at all, finding a good cross-court angle. A net touch by Numidor. So USA 2-0 up. Net touch given against Gibb, and I think he's not happy with that. They say the ball's hit the net, not him.
Is it? My second referee called a net touch. Just take Jake not to do like this.
Well, the ball is definitely hit the net. We don't see from that angle whether it caught him, but the thing is, if the ball does hit the net, it can look like perhaps he touched it. So that's the only thing you need to do in that situation, is let the volleyball do the talking. The reactions are irrelevant. He might just be a good actor. Casey was off and running a little too early. And at the end change, the USA lead by one. Way across the net. Nice little shooter this time though from Patterson over the top. As the Olympic rankings are concerned, Jake Gibb, Casey Patterson are at number four, Numidor and Varenhorst are number three, with 100 points more than they have. So this is a big game for these two, because it does mean whoever wins this one is going to end up with more points than the other one, and it could mean that for Gibb and Patterson, they could potentially overtake Numidor and Varenhorst if they win. Chicken wing is going to work, stays in play. Numidor has to reset, that's a good angle. And Patterson's gone with the wrong hand. Why are you saying that? There's still by no means a done thing here for the USA. That's a nice play in the end from Gibb Patterson. Dalhousie Lucena have 5,720 points. Gibb Patterson have 5,420 points. Triborne and John Hayden have 4,850 points. All it needs is one good event for Bourne and Hayden and one blowout for either of the other two teams. It could be trouble, but it's just certainly a nice way for Gibb and Patterson to go about their business. Getting to a final four of the Grand Slam is big points for them. Because that one is ricocheted off of the block and out.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah. easy lead. An unforced error at this time. Aaron Horst doesn't find the sideline, so the USA get themselves a 3-point lead here. Best ever finish for Gibb and Patterson was a ninth together as a pair. Gibb did have a fifth with Sean Rosenthal back in 2012. Chase is on here. Well, that was unlucky. If that had not hit the net, it would have gone down. And it's the USA who get the point. Lovely chase. And really, it was on a plate, wasn't it? Should have been put away. Patterson it is, though, who does put it away. Timeout called by the Netherlands. It's the first time the USA have been in a televised match this year. The last time was in the Grand Slam in Poland, where they were in the final, finished second. But this year they've gone ninth in Puerto Vallarta, ninth in Rio, ninth in Vitoria, fifth in Qatar, fifth in Fortaleza, fifth in Cincinnati. So having gone out at the quarter-final stages, so we have a look at some of the highlights from the set. Just when they need to, in the Grand Slam, they get themselves into the TV games, into the final four. Massive swing from Baron Horst. And now we have the technical timeout. Just a huge spread block from Gibb. Didn't even look. He just protected his head, closed his eyes, and hoped for the best. Not the best way to come back from a timeout. dig. It'll go over the baseline and out of play. Still got the spring, still got the height, 40 years of age, not showing any signs of slowing down. Good work from Jacob Gibb. Very narrow block, I should say, completely the opposite of what was being done by Jacob Gibbs. Always had his hands touching each other as he tried to go up and stop the line. Varenhorst now with the serve. No trouble at all for Casey Patterson. Did play some pro ball in Chile after he finished his college volleyball. Enjoying plying his trade on the beach. The late bloomer, really, as far as beach volleyball is concerned, coming out onto the FIVB, onto the World Tour at the age of 31. There's going to be trouble if Gibb carries on like that. He threw a hissy fit the first point. He's doing it again here. Now he gets a yellow card. He was told to stop the first time, but emotions are high. He thinks that shouldn't have been an issue. Well, he didn't touch the net, did he? The referee said he did. That's why he's upset. Maybe it's the minutest of touches. The USA are leading by four. They're not in any trouble here. They could end up being their own worst enemy if they're not careful. Nice work from Patterson. Mind you, any of you that have been in that situation playing in a match, an important match, at whatever level it might be, and the referee calls you for a net touch that you truly believe you didn't make, it's harsh, very harsh. Okay, good block out. There's no point trying to hit the sand against Varenhorst. Just want to see where his hands are and make them your best friend. And that's what Gibb has done. Good pick up from Varenhorst. And somehow he managed to roll it past Gibb, who just takes a breath and goes, okay, fine. That's a great block. That was a great pickup. Oh dear. You could see quite clearly, couldn't you, that Gibb thought he was going out and then suddenly realised, what am I doing? It's going in. And then had to play it. Unsuccessfully. Just watch, it's like, yeah, going out. Oh, no, it's not. Oh, it is now. That's play from the Netherlands. Will it come over? No, no, it won't. What a shame. Brilliant chase from Varenhorst. Good pick up by Numidor. And then another good play. But in the end, it's the USA who take the point. Full on dive. Cracking. That'll go down for dive of the day, won't it? Good hustle from the US. Thank you. Well, he was 10 minutes late for that one. Good hustle from the States, but this time it's the Netherlands who take the point. Now, what was Gibb doing here? Not much. Lovely. Just up high, nice and straight. High contact point. Rolling it to the line to bring out a set point. Nice pick. Good work from Numidor. Oh, clever from Casey. He could see the Netherlands were in close to the net. He's played it straight back over. USA take the first set, 21-17. Netherlands weren't expecting that to come back. So the first set was a good effort from the USA, but not the best of starts. The second, Netherlands with the opening point. Varenhorst. Thank you. again, Gibb just turns away, doesn't he? Shies away from the ball. And he's going with the block, gets himself in a position and then just protects his face. That really good first set, USA just seem to have gone to sleep a little bit. Trouble is, the USA quite an emotional team. Of confidence players, really. And when that goes, it can be trouble. That will help restore the confidence. To come over. Oh, it didn't touch the block then, so we were able to get another swing. It initially looked like it had caught Gibb as it went past him. Patterson's made a couple of good digs. Can he convert? Yes, he can. Turning the hand to put it cross court. And the USA very much back in this one now at 6-6. Exactly where the USA were as he went to pokey that ball over. He's shaking his head as he talks to Barinhorst. It was a bit of a gift, wasn't it? As Patterson then hammers it down. Netherlands calling timeout. Well, that was off the foot, but at least it looked like it was off the foot. He's hit it so quick, it may well have hit him on the arms. I will apologise now, obviously, if it was. We'd get to see the slow-mo. My first thought was it hit Patterson on the foot and came up. It was a monster swing, wasn't it, either way, from Barinhorst. Nibidor with the serve. Wasteful. On the ball by Patterson, just. And he stayed out of the net as well. It's a nice play as Nibidor puts it down, not getting perhaps the applause he might like. The crowd seems to be on the side of the US a little bit, but that's a brilliant shot from the 39-year-old. Give Netherlands a two-point lead. Patterson bounces back. So the technical timeout, USA lead by a set, Netherlands lead the second by a point. Just like that, the USA are back in it. Massive block from Gibb. Gibb screaming at Patterson to chase after it. Said come on, but quite loudly. He was expecting Patterson to run it down. He was sat cross to run the line down. Look at him. Come on, he's screaming. Serves in a row. Now that means the Netherlands stay in front. Gibb comes up with the unforced error. It's going to be tough now for the Americans. They have the side out. That could have been an awful lot tougher, couldn't it? Had that ball not bounced the way it did off the net. Good dig. Gibb almost made it. However, Barinhorst wraps it off the block and out. And the USA can't get back into this one at the moment. It's looking like this set is going to go the way of the Netherlands, which means if that is the case, we'll head into a decider. Now that unforced error probably is going to be enough now for the Netherlands. Saying that was a free ball over. He actually hit it quite hard, even though he was on the sand, hard enough for it to be allowed to be played high hands defense, at least as far as the referee was concerned. Points required then for the Netherlands. Only 1 point required now for the Netherlands. Huge block by Barinhorst. Set point for the team in blue as Patterson is put down. Set point for the Netherlands. Patterson with the serve. He's going for it. Well, it doesn't matter. Netherlands take the second set. 21-16. We're heading into a decider. First to 15 goes to the final. Yeah. USA looking for the first point of the third set, which they get. Oh, great pick up from Patterson. Gibb plays it over because it touched his block, and that'll be two touches against Numidor in the set. He'll be disappointed, but he won't be arguing. Big throw down. Free ball. For the USA, could be 3-0. Well, it won't be though, because Varenhorst makes a monster block. Varenhorst with the serve. Can he back up that previous block? Well, that's a shame. Oh, that's magnificent. It looked like it wasn't going to be coming back. But when it does at the second time, it's the USA who have the point. Brilliant effort from the Netherlands. Somehow, Varenhorst gets it, but also Numidor gets himself back up and able to play it, but he couldn't then get across the court to deal with the cut shot. So Gibb Patterson leading 3-1. To get on with it, doesn't want any time delays, any wasting of time. Numidor with the serve. That's going to be too tight to the net. Oh, good joust, which Patterson has won. Well, Numidor's taller, heavier, but it's Patterson who is smarter. Great work from Casey Patterson. Well, that one, not so great. Well, there's a lot of effort from Patterson. But as he went to jump, didn't actually get out of the sand, did he? Certainly not high enough to clear the net with his spike. Well, the USA have the lead, but that great start they had, that big lead they had, has been eaten away. Good chase. Oh, that's quality from Numidor. Former Dutch indoor international, who is a swing hitter, showing all the skills. That was brilliant. So all square as they change ends. A slight advantage to the USA because they're siding out to take the lead. Patterson the target again. And he's equal to the task. Wasn't any angle to go line. The antenna definitely in the way. Well, that was some set from Varenhorst, stuck in the net as he was. That's why Gibb got off the next. He's expecting that to be dug. And an error from Gibb that puts the Netherlands firmly in this one. The angle is good from Gibbs. He gets it off the block and out of play. Sufficiently. Good lead from Jake Gibb. Could do that all day long, show you cross court and then hit the line. So you just wonder whether or not, as Varenhorst nearly lost that ball, almost fell out of his hands. Certainly put him off his serve as he sends that one long. USA reach double figures first. It's too tight. Oh dear. No angle at all. With the block counting as a touch. Block one, two. This had to be played over. But not like that. Varenhorst block to their own ends has been the key for the USA. Every time they've tried to bury the ball in the sand, Varenhorst has been in the way. But the blockouts have worked very well. Still though, nobody can make a real move at the moment. We get the 14-all, we'll keep going until someone gets too clear. That's two in a row now from Varenhorst. Gibb couldn't get onto it. Barinhorst has a go again, and this time he makes sure it goes down to level the scores again. They're going to go cross court against Gibb. And it works. Unforced error from Gibb, and it's advantage the Netherlands. Just putting the ball on to Gibb. But he's able to put it down. Even I can't believe he didn't make that dig. Line block signalled against both players for Gibb. Casey will sit cross court and wait to see what happens. Where was he? Why wasn't he cross court? And he apologises to Gibb, but that's where you need to be disciplined. You have to do what you're going to say you're going to do. So match point then for the Netherlands. Barinhorst has missed his last two serves. At least he makes sure that one goes in. They're going to have a swing for it, Numidor. And he's done it! The Netherlands are through to the final here in Moscow. A magnificent result for the World Championship silver medalists from 2015. They have beaten Gibb and Patterson, and that's how they've done it. I don't quite think Numidor was expecting to be brought in that close for the hug. No hard lines to the USA. They will battle for bronze. But it's the Netherlands who are through to the final here. Wasn't quite to be, was it, for Gibb and Patterson? And down waiting on the sand, Tim Simmons can talk to our winners.
Congratulations, guys. A very close match, nip and tuck. I think you took your first lead in the third set at 13-12.
Yeah, it was just holding on, holding on. Like, they were... Every time when we got close, they made another break, so always behind, always behind. The only thing you can do is just struggle on and try to make your side out. And the momentum switched a little bit in the second set by good blocks by Chris. And then Chris played an awesome game and they helped me a lot today.
Chris, obviously you started slow in this tournament with two losses, pool play, but you came back strong.
Yeah, you got to survive the group stage and after that it's just on. Keep on winning and you'll make the final. Keep on winning and you win the final.
What about a possible matchup with Allison and Bruno, or are you just satisfied with this win, especially when you beat another Dutch team today?
Yeah, I mean, I don't care who's in front of us tomorrow. We just need to recover now. There were a tough few days, like we struggled in pool, a lot of three-setters, and just recover and then we'll see tomorrow. We make a good plan and hope for the best.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations indeed, a potential World Championship matchup tomorrow then in the gold medal if Allison and Bruno get through. Confirmation of the score for you. Numidor and Barinhorst have booked their place on the podium and in the final. What will be the colour of their medal? That remains to be seen. Here are the highlights. Our coverage from the second semi-final today. We hope you've enjoyed it. Seven matches down, one more to come. Hope you can join us for that. But until then, from all of us here in Moscow, it's time to say goodbye.